Okay. So I realize that I think these are just based on foam, so I think that is right. I'm not sure what significance that holds, if anything. Over. I haven't been this way, have I?
I've never been in this part of the apartment before.
Beryl Underwood. Oof. Particularly challenging subject. Knows more about finance than I do. He sees me as a subordinate. He's highly suspicious of me. All of his actions are well thought out. I've never tried to make a mistake. In addition to lobbying in developed countries, he lobbies in other ones. Lobbying about how sugar is healthy. So he's mostly doing his business. Doesn't seem like anything that would be suspicious necessarily.
Beryl, will you ever change?
Armed militias in South America. Destabilize local governments hostile to his companies. But Kasparov of business, always several steps ahead, makes him particularly difficult to read even for me. Recover or destroy, otherwise suspicion level will increase. I wonder if that's shared across all the characters, or do they have their own separate ones?
I understand better now. The prince asked more for a complete report on the members of the Primogen.
Looks like car keys.
Someone tossed a bunch of stuff in this bag in a hurry to leave. Poems in Lydia's mother tongue.
Okay. What was that? Oh, more coins. Oh, phone.
A cell phone. Locked, of course.
Dear Lydia, thank you so much for the book of Emily Dickinson poems you so kindly sent to me. Okay, that doesn't seem like it's pretty important. So the phone code was in the daughter's room somewhere on that board. I think it was, I think I saw it, but I'll have to double look at it. That is a very nice tub.
It must have been used to dress a wound. Bottle of disinfectant. Obviously handled by someone who was bleeding. The concept of a laundry basket seems too abstract for some people.
Okay. Thursday, so the guy said Monday. So it's been a few days since the daughter's been around too. Case of emergency called Pura Vida. Okay, so that worked. That's a no return spot. I feel like we have lots more we can look at. See, her room was, and that's Lydia's. Her room was in here. It's gotta be the M.
Any news, guys?
Why does this keep coming unequipped? Go. So this is the same conversation, but it's from Jason's phone. I'll see if there's anything new. No.
Lydia was killed. It's not pretty.
Is there a 23? 818, he couldn't contact her. Farrell Underwood callback, 95, so that was today, 125. That's when he's at the party. That's, $115.
Dad, thank you, thank you, thank you!
Man you sent to pick me up from school told me I was gonna see Mom. I'm so happy and sorry about yesterday, okay? So happy, thanks, Dad. So she got kidnapped, probably by the person who killed the lady. Because that was after that. Would that have been Monday? Yeah.
Good evening, Jason. I need you tomorrow night at Nakatomi Plaza. We are getting the family together, and I would like to tell them about our agricultural and food business plan. Round up the numbers and bring them with you. Obviously, this invitation cannot be refused. B. Jason, my cousins didn't show up after all. Stay home if you haven't left, or meet me at Hazel's house if you want. Call me back and tell me where you are.
That does seem a little suspicious. Does this only stay equipped if you use it during the conversation?
We're waiting up.
I'm not sure.
CSU for that.
So what's this way? That's a stairway. Is this the same stairway I used to get up here? Yes. Oh.
This is where I met Moore for the first time.
picture.
Human logic is beyond me. What's the point in doing that?
What? What is that? Just a bunch of tore up shit? Richard Sinton. Renovation Acquisition Project. Okay. Dragon?
A souvenir from the Hong Kong Stock Exchange.
Take all those old coins.
Nice collection. Working for us has its advantages.
Nothing about this. More coins. This is high up.
Lydia and June at the beach.
And they put Pura Vida all over the place. Key to archives. Have I come across archives?
A safe. Now we just have to find the code.
Oh yeah, it's her birthday. The answer phone, she's just in a week ago. I don't know what's going on, let's send them over. Booking confirmation. Heavy jet chartered for Boston Hong Kong trip today at 5:45. So he's planning on leaving after the party. What was her birthday? 4/9/11? What are those bloodstains? 04? 09? Inspect. Dunham. Rather easy to understand all of his financial transactions. Almost entirely dedicated to his research. Nothing to fear from his things. Traceability. He noted his needs are growing. Expansion of the scope of experiments following his recent breakthroughs. From a purely financial point of view, the results are not there. Other than that, Dunham does not get involved in the management of his affairs as long as the sums he requests reach him quickly. However, he instructed me to inject resources into private institutions for individuals suffering from psychological issues. I believe he would like to keep an eye on his most interesting cases. He also created a research laboratory that specializes in hypnosis. Sickness is highly confidential as there have not been any major advances.
There was a lot of money involved. We're not going to get a return on our investment anytime soon.
Finally, I recently took the liberty of creating Von Kraft holding to collect income from his activities and invested in reliable areas. However, I must admit that the profits are lower than expected today. An institution like Boston's Red Salon, in particular, with its undeniable success, receives the support of many eminent members of your organization, and yet this is not reflected in the salon's accounts. Dunham is secretive on this point. Mr. Underwood has taken over management at the venue. Do not have access to enough elements to substantiate my allegations. However, While my forecasts are not always 100% accurate, they cannot be far removed from the reality of the situation. The only conclusion that can be drawn from this is that capital is disappearing without my knowledge. I recommend a thorough investigation on the Red Salon and shed light on this major issue. But that could be Dunham or Beryl.
There was a lot of money in.
Oops.
Going to get a return on our investment.
Hold on. There we go.
A thank you letter from Fortress Security. After the installation of a system for more. Maybe he kept it for reference.
Installation of product 442452.
A thank you letter from Fortress Security. After the installation of a system for more, maybe he kept it for reference. Lydia and June at the beach.
Is there anything in that? No. I don't think I've gone on this computer, did I? Yeah, I did. Okay. What's that? Oh, clicking.
A souvenir from the Hong Kong Stock Exchange.
Is that the same guy?
Son of a bitch wasn't messing around. Have you seen all that cash?
Stock portfolios. Moore doesn't just manage the Camarillas business.
Oh. Here. And here. I can't interact with them. Oh, this is the archives. Confidential file on Dijon. Not the most active member. He's not very interested in accounting. Let me see. Manage his small fortune as I see fit. Laundering money to deal in occult objects. He's amassed enough money to get by on his own, despite his erratic financial habits. For this reason, I recommend you have a substantial substantial amount of money by ceasing your contributions to him. Of course, if this was a means to ensure his loyalty, I will let you be the judge of whether or not this is a good idea. Siaka is what we call a cash cow, although he describes himself as a collector. He spends his money freely on things that are important to him without any real consideration for the profit he could derive from them. Cult activities, cult objects, and ancient works that are rather difficult to transport.
Are you making plans in case things go south? Or are you planning to leave us?
I'd also like to draw your attention to the fact that Mr. Siaka recently invested in a property near Salem. Apartments, warehouses, garages, the same type of properties and sizes as the property he currently owns in Boston. It would appear that he intends to establish a secondary residence.
Auction. Acquisition of Lot 87. Dijon Siaka. A trumpet belonging to Don Ellis.
Don't know who that is. Is that all there is? There's a third floor. Systems.
A fortress security catalog. They install highly secure rooms. I've already seen that name on a letter. What was the reference again?
It was 4425452. Hidden panic room. I think that's what we already opened by doing the call Pura Vita.
There. Have you found anything?
I'm going through the financial records. Moore managed the accounts for a lot of big names in Boston. Here, take a look for yourself.
Oh.
Anything worth noting?
Honestly, I don't know. It's not my field. We'll have to take it to the Financial Crimes Unit to see what they make of it.
Get in touch if you find something.
All right.
Nobody told me there would be a retainer here.
That's what I was saying. It's like everything around here is suspicious, but I guess I have to talk to her first. Or do I have to talk to her with the thing up?
What are you playing at?
Oh, I beg your pardon?
Don't mess with me. Who are you?
Calm down, Mr. Bazzori. I meant no disrespect. I work for the Council.
Why would the Council have sent her without warning me?
Most of the time, they send me to clean up.
Are you behind this?
No, I got here after it happened.
Let's see how much she knows. All right, what have you found?
Oh, I'm a little embarrassed. I'm not really allowed to talk about my missions.
So that's still equipped. Plus one to dominate. Given her position, Zhara is particularly complicated to keep an eye on. Wouldn't go so far as to call her paranoid, but every match is from her use of special codes that go through intermediaries who are always changing. Such a security conscious client. Financial activities are few and far between, consist mostly of bribes and information trafficking. Almost impossible to track down the points of origins or various destinations of funds outside Boston. Personal connections, suggestive web of well-paid informants, as well as a number of shell companies that seem ideal for hiding espionage activities, IT, private protection, telecommunications, maintenance and repair company in Cambridge Port. For rest, mostly matter of living expenses, Drury goes through a number of intermediaries, which makes any attempts at tracing these transactions difficult. Install several in-house software programs on my devices to make them secure against hacking. Experts inform me that data packets are being transmitted in apparently random, inexplicable manner. I will determine the source. I initially thought it was a bug, and after a thorough verification, the data is systematically concerned information about transactions related to B&L Corp, that's Beryl, Rosamond, Hilda, Boncraft, Dunham. Nothing alarming in theory, as these banal transactions cannot reveal any sensitive information, but it appears that it's not as random as we first thought. It would seem to be most unexpected and unwelcome form of surveillance. Perhaps Miss Tory could enlighten us on the matter. So she's spying on him. Alright, let's see what news is, even though I'm not hungry. $13 out of $100. Okay, so those are expensive, but having one extra point is very important, apparently. How is that a tie?
I don't have time for this. Give me what you have.
What I've got. Of course, sir. Here, that's everything.
You made the right choice. Tell me exactly what they asked you to do.
I got a message at 2:20 telling me to go to this address. I was supposed to pick up more and some financial documents. After that, I was supposed to wait for further instructions.
Well, yeah, let's just use it again.
Read the message you received.
Target, Jason Moore. Address, 200 Clarendon Street, top floor. Exfiltrate target if possible. Otherwise, final elimination. Destroy Katapata's files. Complete mission for further instructions.
If I had gotten to Moore before you did,
I would have had to take him out.
Well, you could have tried. Well,
I hope I'm not going to have any trouble.
Katapate's files. I don't want her interfering with me.
But there's no point in having two of us here. You're going to go home now.
Very well, Mr. Bazzori.
+3 willpower, but I was full on it, I think. Maybe not, I think I had 12 before. Now I am very hungry. What was the trait? That just flips those around. It said I gained a trait. +2% success rate in ties. I just want hunger to generate would be very good. Alright, so there were two people I could feed on. Let's go find them. So it's just linking all this stuff to her now.
Ugh, what a mess.
It's good I didn't waste all my hunger on those, because I needed a lot to deal with her. Camera guy was around here, right?
Rather not know how much that's worth.
Meet me there.
Okay, sure.
See, is his tree different from the others? There we go. Yeah, he has, different stuff. He has a Sense the Unseen instead of Auspex. He's the only one with Fortitude, but everyone seems to have Dominate.
To rest.
Melancholic? Where are those again? I don't affect at that. How do I find out what that does? Might not know till the end. Alright, so I already fed on him. Just two hunger is probably alright. Because I can get a lot more than two out of a person, so I don't think I need to go get the other one. Did I check up here? I don't think so. This dude eats a lot of pizza.
It was my greatest pleasure before. Now everything tastes like ashes.
Cigar. Magnetic key.
I should put some money on that.
Nothing there.
Oop. Live stock prices. I had fun for a while too. At first.
Officer Baker, can I help you?
Were you the first person to arrive at the scene of the crime?
Yes, sir. My partner and I were the first to get here.
Just tell me about it.
We got the call around 2:20. The caretaker had called because a resident was injured. It took us about 20 minutes to get here. The poor guy was in a panic. He told us he'd seen one of the tenants, Jason Moore, enter the building, and he looked hurt. He was being held up by his two bodyguards, and he was bleeding a lot.
There were two bodyguards.
Did he see the wound?
Yeah. He said the victim was holding his right hip. So I went upstairs with the caretaker. We saw blood in the elevator and on the landing. I rang the doorbell, but nobody answered, so the caretaker opened the door. I identified myself. There were traces of blood leading down the hall away from the entrance, and just after that, I found the decapitated body.
Did your partner come with you?
No, he stayed in the foyer to secure the entrance to the building.
Did you touch the body?
No. There was nothing I could do to help him. So I secured the scene. I put my gloves on to take his ID out of his jacket pocket so we could identify him. Then I called it in.
Where was the caretaker during that time?
I told him not to come inside, but he followed me. When he saw the corpse, he was really shaken. He wouldn't let go of me.
Then what did you do?
I called for backup. They told me that forensics would get here as soon as they could. They were out at another case. That was their top priority.
After that?
I secured the entrance to the apartment.
Oh. I guess I can't do that one.
After that, I searched the ground floor. There was nobody around, but from the looks of things, somebody searched the apartment. When Sergeant Lehane got here, she took care of upstairs. It's a good thing, too, because it took everyone else another 15 minutes to get here. She didn't find anyone there.
So there's no sign of the family, then?
Nothing. The place is empty.
Oh, here we go. So persuasion, 50% if I do 3 willpower. I got a lot of points, but this one loops back. Let's go with this one. Let's just do 2. I don't think I need the extra one there.
That's it?
Oh, yeah. The guys in the parking lot said they saw one of Moore's cars leave after he came home. Hey, do you think the wife was in cahoots with one of the bodyguards to get rid of the husband?
Except she was blood dry. I'm not so sure about that theory.
Yeah, we already know that's not the case. Plus one back, so it only cost me 4 overall. That's not too bad. Is there anything else to get from him?
Sorry, Agent Smith, but I'm a little busy right now.
No? Nothing in there, okay. So, in that case, I think... Oh yeah, we read that. I think the only thing that I'm missing would be downstairs then. Oh, right. Oh, there's an undiscovered safe zone somewhere. Let's see, so I think it's downstairs through the kitchen. So this way. Right there, dude. Laundry room, yeah. And we got a consumable key, increases technology rating by 1. Okay. Oh, that's a nice elevator. Oh good, it's not gonna make me wait through 6 floors. No, even more than that, it's 4-4.
Can you take a look at the cards, please?
I'll run the plates.
You know it's a video game because everyone parked perfectly. Anything?
Hey, mister. You can't go into the parking garage. It's a crime scene.
Agent Smith, FBI.
Oh, hi, Officer Norton. They didn't tell me you were coming down.
Got something?
Wyatt saw Moore leave at 2:25.
Wyatt?
The parking attendant, pot security guard, pot valet. Anyway, a car that belonged to the victim left in a hurry. Or at least he thought it was Moore, until he found out he got his head cut off. There's skid marks on the ground and signs of a minor accident at the exit. He must have really been in a hurry.
And that was a brutal Boston accent. So he said, somebody left in the car. There's 2 bodyguards. We haven't seen either one of them.
He?
What?
You said he must have been in a hurry. You're saying it was a man.
Oh, no, no. It just slipped out without thinking. It could have been a woman. Do you think it was the murderer?
We're not sure of anything at this point. I've got a few questions.
Witness.
Where's the witness?
Wyatt, he's in the security booth over there. He's super nice. I don't think you'll need to question him again.
You mentioned skid marks.
Yeah, they're very distinct. They start from his parking space and go all the way to the exit. They clean this place twice a day, so there's no doubt they're fresh. The driver peeled out of here in a hurry.
And you said there was an accident near the exit?
Yeah, minor one. Broken headlight, paint marks. He must have had a hard time handling it.
Do we know what kind of car it was?
Yeah, we called it in. It's the victim's sports car. Wyatt said there's only the sedan left.
It was the victim's sports car.
Did you find anything else?
No, that's it. Since we're still waiting for forensics, we gotta be careful. But you know how it is, right?
Alright.
Let me know if you have any other questions.
so he was over here.
Still looking.
I have a key. File on Hilda. Not directly involved in the world of finance, keen instinct for leveraging assets. Fairly conventional art dealings. A difference between private and business collections. They rarely makes transactions at a loss. Leaves nothing to chance. Day-to-day transactions reflect usual lifestyle of a person of her rank within a prestigious organization. Likes nice things. Guard to the Rosemont Society, her foundation. First being in charge of every single transaction. No question of putting my trusted managers in charge of it. The only leeway I'm given is with regard to the purely financial side of it, which she does not concern herself with. Entirely focused on art, grants to schools, holding conferences, expositions. Not well known to the public, Rosemont Society is a major player in the art world. Naturally requires significant financial power, which is why the foundation is courting the world's greatest fortunes. And companies who seek recognition or just want to burnish their image. Quid pro quos in exchange. Arts donated for free, invitation to galas, good press. Imperial Underwood was approached by Miss Andrews to stimulate financial contributions to the foundation. They seem to have set up an organization that deals in art trafficking.
Hilda's planned for everything, even her eventual end.
One particular issue requires your attention. Miss McAndrews has asked me to drop a sort of will for her. I was surprised by the request in and of itself, as I am not a lawyer. I have no experience in drafting this sort of document. Given your longevity, I was under the impression that inheritances were not a concern that preoccupied you. However, this was not the question I wanted to draw your attention to. Rather, I wanted you to be aware of the identity of the beneficiary of most of McAndrew's property. Her belongings are to be bequeathed to M.M. Lewis. Don't have the pleasure of having met, who would appear as relatively little involved in your court. Seems to me there is a risk of having so many assets removed from your circle of influence if Miss McAndrews were to pass away. I recommend the utmost vigilance on this matter. Well, we already knew she still had a thing for her. Anything else? So having removed that, does that make my suspicion go down? It does not.
Clearly, the driver had difficulty handling it.
Okay. I'm guessing none of these other cars have anything of interest, though this one's actually not parked perfectly. I guess I can't talk to her. There's some rats. That was not perfectly in the same exact manner as the other car.
Agent Smith, FBI.
Oh, hello. McLean. Can I help you?
Just a few questions. Moore had several cars, right?
Yeah, I think so. But you better talk to Wyatt about that.
Your colleague mentioned an accident that happened tonight. Do you know anything about it?
Oh, no. Not yet. Wyatt told us everything he knows.
They seem really weird about whoever this Wyatt is.
You questioned the caretaker when you arrived?
We didn't have to. Wyatt told us everything we needed. He's a real team player.
Yeah, that's weird.
If you want to find out more, you should talk to
Wyatt.
Oh, so you know him too.
So I could feed on that guy if I need to, but at 2 hunger, I'm probably fine. Is that the one that got busted?
A vehicle ran into the wall.
Oh, then sure you can't feed on rats, I know that.
I won't stoop that low.
Security. So that's a car I could get into if I... Can't mess with the handle. Oh, here's another safe zone, so that's the last one. Is there anything in here?
Access to the trash is restricted here.
Why, you weren't here and I haven't been able to get to the trash can scan. Would it kill you to leave the door open? Some of us have work to do. We know that there was something dumped down the trash. Else I blood there.
To find a way to open it.
Okay, so there's not anything I can do there. Let's see if there's anything else out here. Oh, that's where I came from. Elevator.
Hurry up. Something, guys.
We're waiting for the forensics.
Hello, Mr. Bezori.
You must be mistaken. I'm Smith. Agent Smith.
Yeah, sure.
Do I know you?
Everyone knows who you are.
I knew that guy was suspicious.
Is it just me, or are you pals with all the cops around here?
Let's just say I'm pretty intuitive. You know what I mean. In the years you've been hunting us, you've acquired a hell of a reputation among our kind. I didn't know you would come. I'm not looking for any trouble. I didn't do anything wrong.
Just who the hell are you?
Me? I'm nobody. The name's Wyatt Alvarez. I was embraced 5 years ago.
A thin blood. I spent years hunting them when Quentin King ruled Boston.
Unfortunately for me, the blood of my sire was already weak. So I can still catch glimpses of the sun, but I don't have actual powers.
Do the kindred know you exist?
Yeah. I followed the rules, but the prince told me he never wanted to see me again, so I try not to make waves. I try to help out here and there. I'm hoping someone will notice one day, and I'll be allowed to become a true kindred.
That's not very likely, if you ask me.
Okay.
I hope it works out for you.
I'm doing what I can. Actually, if you could put a word in with the prince, I'd be eternally grateful.
I don't get involved in that kind of thing.
Of course, obviously. But seeing as how I'm already working for your child, Mr. Underwood, I thought that maybe...
You work for Beryl?
Yes, I also work at a red salon, a couple of hours each day.
What do you do there, exactly?
Cleaning, mostly.
That could be suspicious of Beryl.
What are you doing here, then?
I thought it was a pretty cushy gig. It leaves me with a lot of spare time, even while I'm on the job. And it also means I can live at night.
Who created you?
His name was Victor, but he died last year.
Are you involved in what happened up there?
Not at all. I swear, I've got a sweet job here. I'd never risk it.
So what happened?
I've got no clue. My shift started at 10 p.m., as usual. The sixth floor attendant left around 11. At midnight, one of Mr. Moore's bodyguards came down to get the car. They were going to a party, apparently. I didn't see them come back. Then, around 2:20 or so, one of Mr. Moore's cars went flying out of here. It hit the wall near the exit.
Who was driving?
Did you see who was behind the wheel?
No, it's got tinted windows. I thought it was Mr. Moore at first. But from what happened upstairs, I doubt it now. Hey, were you the one who...
You really think if it was me who did it, I'd be standing around here trying to figure out what happened? Did you recognize the car?
Yeah, it was his sports car. The only one like it here.
Okay.
What can you tell me about Moore?
I saw him a lot. He's the tenant I got to know best because of his working hours. And he was the most generous when it came to maintaining his cars, too.
Anything in particular about Mrs. Moore?
Yeah, I see her every once in a while. Sometimes I see her with a girl, coming back from vacation. Sure is good they weren't here tonight.
What makes you say that?
Well, Mrs. Moore's car. I haven't seen it in the garage for weeks, and she's the one who took the girl to school. Mr. Moore told me they were on vacation, and he was going to go join them soon.
Did you see the bodyguards today?
James came by earlier this evening to move Mr. Moore's car, but I haven't seen them since.
How do you open the dumpsters in the garbage room?
What dumpster?
The dump... Are you toying with me?
No, but the cops already looked. There's nothing there.
Confrontation. Fight to convince the other person the result of a confrontation has an impact on how a story will play out. Confrontation has a number of stages, depends on the goal of the confrontation. Each stage ends with either a win or a miss. There's a maximum number of misses allowed for each confrontation. If you exceed this number, you lose.
Open
one
it.
Miss allowed.
Mr. Bizzori, I promise you won't find anything there. And I can't open it anyway. It's for staff only. Why do you want to go through the trash anyway?
Let me make sure I get my item equipped. I do. See, increases tech, increases willpower. Neither of those are going to help you right now. See, I feel like this would be a good answer, but I honestly feel like you're probably going to have to use willpower. Oh, he has a high intimidation 3. Hold on, he has a chance of... I'm pretty high in willpower. I'm going to go ahead and use the 6.
You sure you want to piss me off, Wyatt?
No. Of course not, Mr. Bizzori. That's not at all what I wanted to do. Listen,
We're just gonna forget this conversation ever happened. And...
Excuse me? You didn't just try to corrupt my memories, did you?
Oh, no. I'm so sorry, Mr. Missouri. I shouldn't have. I know. How can I make it up to you?
Be serious right now. Oh, you can really use that will cover up fast.
You're taking a big risk by messing with someone like me. I'm sure that's not news to you.
Yes, I know. But it doesn't have to come to that. I meant no disrespect. Obviously.
Obviously. So you could open this dumpster for me. Open it now.
Just promise me you won't touch anything. Some of my stuff is in there. Please, don't touch it.
So I don't have any willpower left. I got several coins, that's why. Alright. Should I use another one? I have just one left.
I give you my word that I won't touch anything. That's the best I can do.
Really?
Don't make me say it again.
All right, all right. Your reputation precedes you. I can take you at your word. All right. It's open.
Wouldn't you rather tell me what you're hiding in there?
Well, I cook a little. A guy's gotta survive. I don't have to tell you that. I don't make a whole lot of money here.
What do you cook?
Oh, a little of everything. But I've got all my stuff in there. And there's some pretty rare ingredients.
Rare?
Yeah. And kinda illegal, too.
Such as?
In some recipes, well, I use vials of Kindred's blood, for instance.
Whose blood?
Well... it depends on what I can find.
Okay, but what have you got right now, exactly?
If I tell you, can it stay just between us?
You're not fucking going to start again.
Okay. Okay, I managed to obtain some of Quentin King's blood.
Oh. No way.
But of course, this guy's the perfect patsy. I almost pity him. King answered the beckoning at the same time as the rest of the city's elders. It can't be his blood.
One more thing, boss.
Don't call me that.
I hope we'll meet again, Mr. Missouri.
Alright, so I got 3 back, but I had to use a lot of resources to get through that.
An old glass bottle. Taken from the trash.
No, it said this was updated. Plus 1 difficulty in psychology? Oh, that sucks. Might have to stop using the thing here. Because that's really starting to hurt. Thin Blood Watch?
There's nothing in it.
Your opponent cannot focus while you are focusing. Chance of success and disciplines increases by 24% in case of a tie. Risk of opponent focus increases by 25%. Let's kind of cancel that if you're focusing, which you kind of have to all the time to even have a chance of winning. I'm not going to put it on now because I don't have any willpower to focus, but that'll probably be useful later. Alright, back to the garbage. So this is the one he uses, but this one looks like bloody.
Ugh, packaging to be recycled.
Nothing.
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 Nothing of interest. Wasn't expecting to see you here. Woo. If it was a bodyguard who died in the lobby, where the hell is Moore? Ugh, packaging to be recycled. Garbage.
So here's his stuff. Let's inspect it.
Why, it's makeshift lab. And it's not meth.
Well, that's good.
Rusty cans.
Oops. What is that? What is that?
Who would want to take that? Empty soda cans. Old chicken feet. A shoe with worn out leather. I wonder what he's cooking with that garbage.
Man, I don't know if I want to take those or not. Alright, I don't know why I don't do this. I have to scum quick and find out if there's consequences to taking this stuff. Answer. Okay, so I don't know. I guess let's take it.
Why, it's makeshift lab, and it's not meth.
Lockpicking tool and vitae. So it helps dominate, increases security rating by 1.
How
How can I help you, Agent Smith?
I went through your trash.
So? Are you interested in one of my ingredients?
That's not really what I've got a problem with.
What?
You didn't tell me about the man's head in a plastic bag.
What? But what the hell? Is it more?
No. That head belonged to one of his bodyguards.
But it wasn't me, Mr. Missouri, I swear. I don't know anything about it.
Actually, I think I do. It doesn't seem like you did
okay,
know about that.
I believe you. I found your cook shop.
You didn't touch anything, I hope.
Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Mr. Missouri.
So, what's it like to be a thin blood?
You're curious, aren't you? Usually, you hunt us down without asking any questions.
There are rules, Wyatt.
Yeah, but I never asked to be this way. If you look at it that way, I'm innocent, if that means anything to you.
You've got a point. Your sire is the guilty one.
Yeah. You can't judge a child for his parents' crime.
I know. You shouldn't be hunted. So, what's it like to be a thin blood?
It sucks. Yeah, I can still go outside during the day, but it's not all it's cracked up to be. The descendants just can't understand. Sure, it's nice.
More than nice. I've been roaming the night since 1745. Do you have even the slightest idea what that does to you? How it changes you, without even realizing it. Without wanting to. It eats at you from the inside.
But I'm still not complete. So, if I had to choose, I'd rather live at night and be like you. Thin buds are the dregs of society. We're always wondering what's gonna happen to us. You, of all people, should know that. If we want to be like you, even a little bit, we have to come up with potions that have a temporary effect.
Okay.
Happy to help.
So I think I'm done down here. And the one thing was a point of no return, so I might as well feed on one of these guys.
Any news, guys?
Nothing yet.
Not her. The guy over there, maybe? I remember one of them was. So probably wouldn't have to watch the whole thing every time. It's a bit long. But I don't think there's any way to speed through it. Controlled hunt. Plus one additional hunger eliminated on a controlled hunt. Let's see, what was the way? This way. was upstairs in his room. Not there. No. Other side? All right, let's go. My question is, what happened? There's a sword.
Jason, so that's where you were hiding.
Trait. Detective. Minus 15 points. Next cost of deduction. Anything I can get from here? Doesn't look like it.
Huh? What the?
Good evening, Jason.
Mr. Bazzori, how did you...
Maybe think about letting us know the next time you build a private bunker.
It's just that I...
She sent me to find you.
No. Not now. She found out about everything, didn't she?
I don't understand anything you just said, but get up. We're going.
I can't. I absolutely have to catch a plane tonight.
I don't think that's going to happen.
I'm begging you. Please, just let me go.
So psychology is more difficult, so I can't even attempt that. That's a problem. I'm not sure if I can get my suspicion down.
Before we go, what the hell is this mess all over your place?
It's not my fault. I tried to cover up my departure. My bodyguards wanted to take me to the prince right after the shooting at the party, but I couldn't.
Your flight?
Yeah. I wanted to buy me some time. I pretended I had to get some files that were at my house for the prince. Once I got here, I sent James to my office with my car, supposedly to pick up some more files there. I kill Wu by taking him by surprise. I cut off his head and threw it down the garbage chute. I put my college class ring on him and gave him my wallet. I'm sorry, Mr. Bazzori. I had no choice.
You don't do things halfway, do you?
He didn't look like he'd be strong enough to make a clean cut like that, but I guess so. No chance of that, so better not waste points.
We've wasted enough time here. Get up.
I'm not going to be able to go with you, Mr. Bazzori. I lost too much blood. I'm having a hard time staying conscious.
I must take you back to the prince, and that's exactly what I'm going to do.
I'm begging you. I've always refused. I want to stay free.
I'm not really giving you a choice. Drink.
Well, you'll be a ghoul.
That's enough.
June will die if you don't let me go.
Stay behind me.
But who shot him? Somebody at the party?
Stay behind me.
Deceive?
Oh! Agent Smith! Wait! Is that Jason Moore? You found him? Oh, we gotta get to the...
fine, officer. I'll take care of him.
Oh, okay. Sure. Yeah.
Erase memory.
You've never seen us.
I don't want to kill people for no reason. That lowers your humanity. Though I don't think there's a listing for that. It's still, I know, bad idea. Bad idea. Good luck with those stairs, jeez.
Hey, stop! Don't move!
Whoa.
Put your hands behind your head, damn it! On the ground! I'm gonna shoot!
That's enough, officer.
My head. Oh, shit.
Damn, really?
Hands on your head!
Hands behind your head!
Let me see those hands! Let me see those hands!
You won't rush!
Take him hostage.
I swear to God.
On your knees! On your knees! Don't be. If you move, you're dead.
Everyone calm the fuck down. Everyone right. Stay calm.
All right, we're good.
On your knees,
okay.
Put your weapon on the ground.
Look, Jason,
get in the elevator.
It's all right. Do what he says. Put it down.
Freaking everyone, jeez. Another trait? Can I check it? No.
We made it. We made it.
Mr. Pizzori, let me go. If I come with you, you know what's going to happen.
I have to take you to the prince, dude.
Get in the car.
Old school pager, okay. Alright, 200 experience, that makes up a little bit. Detective, make no ways, plus 15% success in rhetoric tie. Let's see. Brought back all the reports, you took the caretaker's statement, you found a ghoul on the police force, you won the confrontation, found a safe, unlocked his phone, found Jason, brought Jason back to the prince. You found all suspicious items that threatened the masquerade. Resonance bonus for fortitude. Alright, let's take a break there.